Welcome everyone. Today we're going to be playing the Ultimate General Civil War, and this is the Battle of Manassas Junction. The first Battle of Manassas Junction, also known as the first Battle of Bull Run. We are playing as the Union, of course, taking up from where we left off. And we are going to be, you know, trying to win this battle, which was, in historically, it was a Union loss. Now, let's see. We're going to be getting reinforcements in from here, including all of the units that I have been creating. Plus, we'll be commanding additional units from the Army of the Potomac. Let's see. I'm going to send this artillery unit here and this artillery unit here. This one will be able to fire on. There should be troops behind this, I'm guessing. Also, they mentioned there's a ford here, so I'm thinking if I was the enemy, I would have troops up there. So I'm thinking I'm going to send two regiments down here. And oh wait, did I get, all right, there we go. I'm going to send this regiment here and this that's perfect. And this regiment is basically just waiting, because if there is no enemy there, I would love to get up and be able to flank. But if there is an enemy, let's see, who do we have? The 2nd New York, 2nd Ohio, and the 1st Ohio. All right. We'll get both of these units and just set them up right here. I'd like to have some cavalry so we could know. We know the enemy holds this position because it's got a Confederate flag there. Yeah. All right, and we know they've got artillery. But we can't see their artillery, which is terrible. I'm setting up in trees. Actually, I'll set up these trees. It'll be okay. Now that the infantry is nearby, the artillery should focus on them. I want to protect my artillery so that I can get off at least a few shots up. They're still focusing on my artillery. Alright, guys, get within range so our guys can fire on them. There we go. We see they have that position. I'm going to move this unit here. Actually, I'll just move them here. There we go. Just to see if the enemy is forward. There, we've got their artillery in sight. I'm marching this infantry forward because I'm pretty sure that there are. Yep, there they are. And it is the first first Louisiana Tigers. They are a very good infantry unit. They're bringing their artillery back, which is odd to me. Alright, so these guys, we'll just soften them up a bit. Alright, Rebel cavalry spotted. They're dragoons too, so they're actually heavy infantry that's mounted, if I remember correctly. We'll give them a volley and see what happens. They're going to charge us, which is not smart. So I'm going to counter charge, because I think we can wear them down. Okay, there is the 4th South Carolina. Okay, they're in a good position. We can't cross that river. But I am going to leave the 1st Ohio up here to deal with them and just hold them in place. Now, I'm going to send the, when we get them down to about 400. All right, turn and hit them. Don't let them flank you. Okay, we routed them. Just fire before they get another volley up at you. Good, we shattered them. All right. I'm ordering the 1st Ohio to deal. Fire! Alright, we're gonna go. And I'm going to send my cavalry here because there's a fort up here and I'm then gonna bring him down. Still not been seen, so we're in good shape. Alright, they're marching in tight formation, but they have no artillery. We have units coming in. There I am. Gonna set up in these woods. And we'll start pressing the attack on the hill. Okay, who's retreating? We could charge, but I'm not going to. I'm going to send the 2nd New York down here. And the 2nd Ohio will just stay there and soak up some of their fire. Oh no. In our maneuvering, I've accidentally tangled with a fortified position. That was not the intent. Why are they being flanked? The idiots haven't turned to Okay, just walk away. Alright, where's the cavalry? Come on. Yep, I anticipated it. Don't tell me. Oh, there's the 2nd New York trying to retreat off the map. But if they reform down here, we're in good shape. Alright, so set up here, guys. Actually, set up here. Stay away from the enemy. Now, let's see what is going on up here. Yeah, lots of good infantry coming in, mostly mine. And as soon as they reform, we'll send them back to hold the Louisiana Tigers in position. The cavalry, which are scout units, are going to... Why are they charging? Just fire and then get out. Okay, now. Fantastic. I'll use the scouts to move this way. Oh, Hampton's Legion is here, which is bad. All right. I'm gonna send... There we go. I hit the charge button and I shouldn't have. Alright. So when this infantry gets ready down in here, I'm going to send them directly against that. Okay, that's what they're meant to do. They're going to destroy that artillery for us. Okay, yeah, lots of infantry. And I want to move en masse. Okay. We're going to move forward, and this unit is going to move forward. From the top of the hill, they may be able to have an advantage that they could... Alright, Franken, okay, we've got even more infantry. I mean, we're in good shape. Plenty of infantry coming from that direction. Alright, we destroyed their artillery. And I'm going to send the scouts around this way. There we go. What I'm looking for. I was hoping to destroy their supply lines. I still don't have control of that, but that's fine. The scouts will continue kind of just peppering them. Maybe wear out their supplies. Ah, we captured it. I'm gonna move the cavalry away so they don't get hit by Hampton's troops. Alright. Walton is in really good shape. As you'll notice, I've beefed up Walton's regiment extremely well. I'm going to move my scouts away, and then I'm going to attempt to get the supplies over here. That will... Alright, the rebels are going to withdraw now. We haven't even actually hit any of the positions that they were needing to hold. We've just got so many troops that now they're having to fall back. Alright, so considering we are now in a really good position, I'm going to use these troops to press forward. And these scouts, which should be moving this direction. And yeah, the supplies need to be moving too. I told you to. Alright, now I'm going to use Loomis, Walton, and Ward. I'm going to have them all move in force this direction while moving these three regiments here. That's just trying to get some semblance of a force going. Now, what do we have up here? These units, Sherman and Keyes, are going to move and cross the river. I'm not going to make the poor First Ohio do that move just yet. I'm going to send the Second Ohio here, and I'm going to have the Second New York just try to destroy. This unit is not in very good shape, but maybe they can destroy the Lynchburg Volunteer Artillery. All right. There doesn't seem to be anything here that I need to deal with, so I'm going to move my artillery up. And the supplies. And the commander. All right. I should have more troops coming. I've got them. All right. Guys, you should have moved onto the field already. All right. Here we go. Now, let's see. We've got a good amount of supplies now, and the enemy is regrouping on this position. So, Stuart's cavalry, alright. Alright, we're going to... He's coming after the supplies, and I'm not sure he knows my scouts are there. He's a much better cavalry unit, though, than we are. So, we're just going to try to slow him down, and then run away. We made him think twice about Thomas Jackson's brigade. That means the Stonewall Jackson. Stonewall got his name, Stonewall nickname, at this battle. So, yeah, there's a good reason that we might not want to tangle with that unit just yet. But history's a bit different. We have a different amount of units than appeared in the original battle, in the real world. Alright, guys. Also, we have a number of troops. Yeah, the scouts were supposed to have run off, but anyway. Get ready there and cover. It would be nice to completely destroy Stuart. That's Jeb Stuart's cavalry. They're very good. Alright, the 4th South Carolina is in really bad shape now. 2nd Ohio is in bad shape, but that's fine. Let's see, what other units do I have? I've got all these units, and I thought I told you to move. Alright, so... As these units move onto the map, it means I'm going to have to... deal with different enemy. I'm going to actually pull Walton back and have him fire very quickly on Stuart and then move back. Alright, we're going to see if we can destroy. Alright. Now, Walton will form this threat right here. Loomis here. Ward will be there. Hoggood here, Otis here, Carlin here. Our artillery will be up on the hill. I'm gonna send the commander up here. All right. These three units. I'm gonna send the first Ohio. Oh, come on. There we go. I'm sending these two units to just press the attack. I'd like to get some... Oh no. Second New York's gonna take a beating. Alright. This unit comes forward to attack them. Hargood goes there. They move there. Loomis cross. Loomis will move to attack. They need to cross the river. And they can cross the river as well. I'm just pushing across before I get the enemy has a chance to move. Alright. 2nd New York is in bad shape. It's going to be tough for them to win this. Yeah, they're breaking. I'm going to let the 2nd Ohio stay there. And the 1st Ohio, I'm actually going to pull over to here and just hold them in reserve. Actually, I'll move them here and hold them in reserve. Where are the other... Let's see. Can you fire on anything yet? Move here. And you move here. Now, my cavalry unit, I'm going to move here just to protect. Alright, we need to get across the water as quickly as possible. Alright, guys, you move up here as quickly as possible. Crossing the river is going to be the most dangerous portion of this battle. Alright. There's the 2nd New York and the 2nd Ohio. I'm moving the 2nd Ohio forward just a bit, and the 2nd New York, I am going to move here into the trees and hope the enemy forgets about them, because I may be able to bring them up if the enemy is pushing on this position. And later in the battle, I'm fairly certain the enemy will be. The 2nd Ohio will get in range and then hit them on the flank. Okay. You may be noticing I'm trying to encircle the enemy at this position, but I'm being careful because I will also be exposing my flank here. But with our artillery setting up here, and I am going to move the commander into range so that he can... And I'm going to go ahead and order Loomis across. And that means we've done the most dangerous portion so far. I'm gonna move Sherman so that he's taking the shots more directly on. And I'm gonna move the 1st Ohio down here. They've kind of rested just a bit. Alright, B is retreating, but he will reform. If you haven't noticed, I just ordered the 2nd Ohio to charge. I'm hoping, and it's a really, really wacky hope, that I might be able to get them to break and completely kind of give up. There we go. But since they're not wanting to, I've now got to leave something to deal with them so that they don't come back onto the field. And for that, I'm going to send the 2nd New York to hold that position, and the 2nd Ohio to hold this side of the river. I'm then going to proceed and get all my artillery across the river. That'll also be easier to resupply and in range of the actual battle. Alright, why is Ward over here? Okay, Ward, cross. Cross the river here. Alright, you guys, it's now time to begin pressing the actual attack. These units, these three regiments, are going to do the actual engagement against the enemy. They are going to push in and make the first attack. I'm moving artillery into position all around the area. as we press down onto the enemy. Actually, I'm going to fire on the Lynchburg volunteer. I think that's what it is. Because I know they're in the middle of the river, and it's a chance to take out artillery completely. Major Carlin has been wounded. All right. Why is Carlin moving this direction anyway? And why are my units falling back? All right. All right, but artillery is coming down on the enemy. It's only a matter of time before the enemy is forced. All right, good. No, cross this, and you guys cross there. These are easy crossings that we'll be able to handle, and you can set up to fire across the river. No reason to get slaughtered or anything. Carlin is falling back. That is not good. I'm going to get the commander closer to them so he can maybe buffet their morale. Oh, their commander got hit. All right, we're losing some of our commanders, which is not good. The 1st Louisiana Tigers is all but gone. All right, so I'm gonna move Walton to attack and get Hoggood out of the water. Sherman is going to proceed on here. And this unit is going to move up this direction as well. The enemy has a lot of troops here, so I may go ahead and move Keys to hold these woods. I know they're not an objective, but it will be useful. With St. Renegade holding that position. We have units in melee. The 1st Louisiana Tigers should be falling back at any time. All right. Good. Ward, keep pressing. We've captured a unit, so I'm going to send them across. Walton, charge. If we're able to hit them, we may be able to capture them. Yep, we captured them. So I'm sending them back across. The reason I wanted to capture them was I don't want these units returning to fight in a few minutes. And if we can get into tight with a... Alright. Why is Carlin doing this? Okay, now they're going to counterattack. This is bad. Alright. We need to get Otis back into position. Alright, we got another unit surrendered. This unit surrendered. So it's now time to move all of our troops forward. I'm going to send Otis into here. No, actually, I'm going to send Otis up here. So Carlin set up here. Otis set up here. Walton set up here. Sherman set up here, right in the high point. All right. Franklin, get up here. Wilcox up here. Power grids there. Loomis here. First Ohio is in good shape. Get into the main position. All right. Where's the New York? Where did New York go? Okay, the enemy did try to cross that way. I'm going to leave that unit there for the time being. Move the artillery to this position. Get this artillery up on these hills. And this artillery here. And I'll leave the scouts to cover. Alright, who's not moving forward? Everybody's moving forward. Good. Except for the 3 regiments that we conquered. Now, I'm going to send this supply train here, this supply here, and this supply here. All right, now, we've got to be careful because I don't want to get any of my troops flanked. Alright, we just completely slaughtered a bunch of their skirmishers. Okay, but Carlin's going to be in bad shape because we're going to have artillery bombardment. This unit will take up its position here. We have enough troops. I'm going to move Hoggood up. We have enough troops that we can rotate through units, I think. Okay, Wilcox needs to take up his position here. They need to get back into position. Keyes does. I ordered Keyes to reform so he wouldn't be flanked. Alright, Hoggood's moving up. Howard's moving up. This is going to be a really bloody battle. Are my artillery units firing? No, they are not. Well, in that case, I'm going to take a huge risk and move artillery. This artillery's in a good spot, so I'll just move all the artillery on that side there. Move Woods here. Should be safe-ish. And move Scales here. He should be safe. And Hunt. I'll move him there. That should be relatively safe. They'll be able to fire right into the area that we're going to be taking probably the brunt of the attack on. I'm going to move these troops here. They're back in good condition. And just order the supplies to get within range so that they can resupply. The 1st Ohio has taken up a good position in a safe position. Alright, fire. Okay, we broke those skirmishers. We won't have to deal with them anymore. Alright, but you'll notice the enemy has a lot of troops, and they're sending them, fortunately, straight towards our strong point. And it's just going to be a bloodbath. Now, if we could get B to move off our flank, then we'd be in good shape. Now, their morale's a bit low. But they do have supplies now. Alright. So, I'm going to send these supplies across the river and into possibly into danger, but they will be close, which will be good. And where is the commander? There, he's helping hold that flank. Because this is going to be where the pressure comes. You'll note there is pressure going to come on this side, but we've got... I'm going to send Ward over to help hold that side. Where's the charge coming? Okay, they're charging Carlin. I'm going to order Franklin to assist. Otis can fire on Smith as they break. We routed Smith, and we routed that, and then I'll order Carlin to... Actually, I'm just going to order Carlin to hold the line. Carlin's lost a lot of troops, and I don't know if you realize it, but Carlin is one of my units in my division. So, yeah, things are not going too great. He's lost a lot of troops. Alright, the enemy's also charged over here. Fortunately, we've got Ward and Wilcox who can help hold that flank. Also, I could bring the 2nd Ohio across, but he's kind of holding the ford. Alright, stop advancing, get in position, Ward, advance, and take care of B. Alright, Sherman will hit Bonham, as Bonham is going to attempt to charge Wilcox. Ward's in bad shape. Keyes will reform, and we'll let him rest, and then he can come forward in a few moments. Alright, Wilcox is broken. Ward will hold B back, I'm sure. Sherman needs to fire, and they have a really high morale on that unit. Wilcox is broken. Alright, but Bonham is just being shredded, so... But then again, so is Sherman. I'm gonna move Walton forward, because it should be noted that we're getting charged again. Okay. Sherman is now going to shift to dealing with Keys. I'm going to bring Keys back forward just to reinforce. Alright, lots of point-blank firing going on here. Artillery's pouring in. We already routed Smith when he attacked over here, so I didn't anticipate too much of an advantage against him. Ah, we're going to fire on Johnston. If we can kill him, come on guys, get a volley off and hit him. What's the time? It's still a good amount of time. If we could kill the commander, we did. Now they're gonna have a problem with morale, which is fantastic. Now Wilcox is good, we'll send him back in. He's not good, but I mean, he's holding on. And again, Carlin's holding on. Smith is charging again. Alright. I'm gonna move the 2nd Ohio across the river. They can give support. Sherman's breaking. Walton's there to hold the line, though. I would like to, and I think I can, move the commander closer to this side to boost morale. But I'm going to make sure he stays in cover. No, 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 stop, guys, stop. You guys can hold right here. The artillery's pounding away at him. Alright, we've got an enemy general holding here. Could I get across the river with my cavalry? If I could, I might be able to find some of their artillery. Alright, Keys has been flanked. That could break us. Yeah, because... Walton, are you firing at anything, Loomis? And then, of course, Franklin. Send Franklin forward to see if we can knock back, actually, you know what, I'm gonna send Franklin forward in a weird move to simply attack, Jackson. The idea being, if we're able to get at Jackson, Elwool is, for some reason, changing positions. He's being called off the line to deal with, to deal with my scouts that are now in the back. Okay. But my scouts can outrun. Alright. Okay, we may have made a mistake. They seem to have more commanders than we do, but we have diverted their troops from, and we took out Jackson, and we'll move all of these troops forward with that one diversion from our scouts. We were able to, and the scouts are still escaping. Scouts will move around. We were able to take out a Stonewall Jackson. And with Jackson off the field, we should be able to win easily. I'm going to order a charge against this artillery, because we may be able to capture it, and that would be nice. Alright. Oh, come on, guys. You guys can overpower them in a second. Alright, it routed. Fantastic. Franklin, form up and deal with Elwell. Alright, so we did lose a few cavalry units in that. but we were able to smash their left flank. Now they are going to charge us, so I'm going to move Carlin to deal with Holmes. Alright, so we are pressing forward on... We are actually supposed to be holding, but I am using very aggressive tactics and pressing forward. Move the 2nd Ohio forward again. Okay, Franklin has broken, but that's okay. I'm going to shift Carlin. And I'm moving the commander back to this side because, again, this side is where the battle is going to be the hottest. The only commander they have is right in the center, Beauregard. Now, the question is, do we grab hold of our artillery? No, we don't. Now, with the commander is needing to stay here and reform these troops. Alright, those supplies have been emptied, but I'm going to retreat them back just in case the unthinkable happens. Oh, no, no, no. I don't want my scouts going in, but I'll let Loomis. Franklin is going to move to here, and Carlin will also deal with Owl. I think I'm saying that wrong. Alright. Alright. Guys, let's see. All of you can just focus on one guy, and then all of you focus on this guy. Actually, focus on that guy and see what happens, except for the 2nd Ohio, which I want to keep up fire on B. Order Ward and the 2nd Ohio to deal with this. Walton, I'm going to order him to point blank deal with Bonham, but move up. Alright, and Sherman will move forward as well. Alright, the battle is about to wrap up in about 45 minutes. Oh no. One of our colonels, I think it was Loomis, was wounded. Carlin was, but he was only wounded, so I mean, we will get him back eventually. But briefly, we won't have him. Alright, Walton, start firing on Smith. Now, do we want to try this again? Yes, we do. We are going to freak them out by bringing the, scouts around behind just for one more maneuver to attempt to drive them back. Alright guys, all of you focus on this. If you all focus fire on Smith, we should be able to just, yeah, there they go. Smith's numbers are just going down, down, down. And if all of you, you two, focus fire on... Why is Franklin not good? Okay. And Loomis, who is one of my units, has been really shattered by this war. Okay, who's charging? B? Is B charging across a river? If they are, they're idiots. I mean, they're a strong unit, but not that strong. Artillery is firing. Okay. Once again, we're bringing Owl back by putting our cavalry in a bit of danger. But that's fantastic for us because that means they will pull their troops away from the actual place where they would make a difference, allowing me to do this. Everybody just focus fire on Hampton's legion. If they do that, I think the odds are that we will be able to shatter them completely and then focus down on Holmes. You'll notice I've now just completely given up on my new command things, because we now have so many troops here against so few. If we're able to just get every possible bullet flying into those woods, we can probably break their units and send them running for cover. Artillery's pulverizing the same unit. I do have to be careful here because Smith is moving that direction. All of my men are exhausted and the battle is almost over. Okay, I'm gonna get the commander back because he's too close to the front and we don't want to lose him like we've killed all of their commanders. Alright. Yeah, it's a general rout. I think this is an amazingly interesting way that the battle has gone. I did not anticipate this. Historically, the Union, who we're playing as, lost this. As you can see, we've changed history slightly. I wonder what that would have done in real life. Would the Confederates have surrendered sooner? Would that have meant that the war would have been over? A lot of the people that lived in Washington came out to see the battle, thinking that it would be the only battle of the war and the war would be over in a couple of weeks. Both sides thought that, but the battle was closer to Washington. That's why the Union. It wasn't, of course. It was a very bloody war. Lasted for a long time, lots longer than a few months. And so I don't know, maybe we kind of changed history, but I don't know what happens with the campaign. So I already know that we've won this battle, and I'm pretty sure based on this that we might win the war, which of course happened in real life, so I would be really upset if I didn't. Alright, so let's see. Today, this has been the First Battle of Manassas, or also known as the First Battle of Bull Run. It was Manassas was a railroad junction, and the creek that we fought over earlier was called Bull Run. That's how it got its name. Anyway, so I believe we've won the battle. Should be winning at any... Yep, there we go. We won. It was a really good victory. First Bull Run, as you see. We had... me as the commander, they had Stonewall Jackson, Beauregard, and Johnson. Those are all three really good commanders. We outnumbered them, except they did have more cavalry, which was Jeb Stuart's cavalry, so that was really good. We had more guns, we had more troops, just generally all good all around. Okay, it was a victory because we held Henry Hill and we inflicted at least 15% more casualties on the enemy. Let's see, how do we do that? Let's see. Yeah, they did lose about 1,000 troops more than we did, a little more than that. They lost a lot more cavalry and way more guns, and also we captured 588 troops. That's what missing means. The best unit in the battle was Keyes, second best was Ward, so that left flank of ours on the end of the battle, that's where most of the fighting was going on. Sherman and Walton, of course. Walton should be getting some promotion somewhere along the line. Let's see. Mark Carlin, which you'll remember him, and Otis, they were both on the right flank during the final portion of the engagement, were both wounded, but Keyes, rightly so, was promoted to Brigadier General. He's not under our command, I don't believe, so we don't get to benefit from that, but Hawgood is, and he got promoted to Lieutenant Colonel, as is Ward, Woods, Scales, I'm assuming that's our battery commander, all of these got promoted to Lieutenant Colonel. No one got killed, so I assume that means we didn't kill any of the enemy officers either. Let's see what we captured. We captured a lot of farmers' muskets. We recovered a lot of our muskets and some palmettos, which is an upgraded musket that I gave some of my troops, so that was really nice. I know Hawgood at that. These are our cavalry they're not muskets, they're musketoons, or they're pistols, so, all right, single-shot pistols. And we also captured 10 six-pounders, which is really nice. And what is this? Ah, Smith's carbine. It's a 50-caliber carbine. So that would have been for probably one of their skirmish units. I know we broke a couple of those. Anyway, this has been Ultimate General Civil War. We've been playing the campaign. This is the first major battle, the Battle of Bull Run, the first one. There'll be another one coming up sometime. Anyway, check back tomorrow to see the next engagement in the campaign. I'm not sure exactly what it is. I think it's just a small skirmish. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit the subscribe button. And check back tomorrow to see the next battle. Thanks for watching.